Sunday to all as we welcome you to today's 16th edition of Earl at Large 2022, your favorite Sunday show right here on DBS TV St. Lucia, live in your face on Facebook and with all earlier shows posted online. It is Sunday, the 17th day of July, yet another Sunday, so stand by for another full day of Earl at Large on your screen, at your home, and wherever you are. Bienvenue cette ici pour l'autre saison Earl à Guacord. C'est le 16e programme nous pour saison Sala à ce 17 jours en juillet l'année 2022. Qu'on la coutume, c'est en l'autre dimanche et en l'autre programme ici à sous DBS. Alors, restez avec nous pour l'autre détinette temps et nous allons garder pour one corner tout doux avec musique, information, portrait et vidéo qui nous a souhaité qui nous tout caille aimé avec nous tout caille apprécié. Alors, la jekou ek one kou dou ek chen si gwe ou. Se Earl a Guacord, se dimanche après-midi a sou journée kote nou ka souhaite tout moun a sou la te, alo a nou manje.
Mon sou piment, se gade gade l'aimant. Mon bon poisson, se gade gade l'aimant. Mon sang citron, tout ça mêlé en bon piment, manger créole, en bon tout rhum, en fouille à pain, en bon poisson.
This week, Papa's thoughts come in a different form, though it's in a new series which is called Lucian Talk. And here's Papa introducing it himself.
Welcome, friends, to this new series of programs called Lucian Talk, Jesus Talk. Since our season is over, our reflections on the Sunday Gospels are over, I thought that I'll continue with just little snippets from the sayings of Jesus. And that's why I'm calling it Lucian Talk, Jesus Talk. For example, in the Gospel from Luke chapter 10, verse 5, Jesus says, "Into whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace be with you.'" Jesus, that's Jesus Talk. Lucian Talk, the first house we entered, "Hello, anybody there? Who there? Open up. How you doing?" Wap dede. Jesus says, as you enter, say, "Peace be with you." Just think of it. If each and every one of us would, when we go into a home and we meet our friends, we can say hello, good morning, and so forth. But as we enter, say, "Peace be with you." We can bring into that home the Spirit of Jesus, the Spirit of peace. So, Jesus says, whatever house you enter into, first say, "Peace be with you." This is Jesus Talk. Lucian Talk, let us follow Jesus Talk.
And here's another Lucian Talk from Papa.
Welcome to Lucian Talk, Jesus Talk with me, Papa.
Mango, mango, mango.
Monsieur, me mango people, if you see mangoes, mangoes all over the place, gutters fill up with mangoes. It's like the Jesus talk in Luke chapter 10, verse 2. The harvest is rich, but the laborers are few. So ask the Lord of the harvest to send laborers into his harvest. Lucian talk. Monsieur, so much mangoes wasting all over the place. Jesus talk. We must ask the Most High, who has blessed us with such abundance, to give us the ingenuity and the creativity
to use, find ways of using all of this rich abundance for the common good of the nation. Lucian talk, Jesus talk.
Welcome back. Like we always do to offer more food for thought after Papa's thoughts and the good wishes of the Earl at large prayer in our shared Caribbean Creole tongue, we have a very special feature for you. Now, last week, we took you on a special TEDx drive into the world of coffee, which drew some interesting comments. But in no case did I hear anyone say anything about they'll stop drinking coffee, nor did I. C'est la vie. This week, we have another interesting, mind-ticking one for you. This time, one we often have another interesting set of questions every time we celebrate someone who gets to live to be 100 years old. Reporters ask the same old questions each time everywhere. What's your secret? What special food you eat? What's your advice to people who want to live to get your age? Well, like with coffee last week, TEDx has also looked at this issue and the results speak for themselves. In fact, see for yourself.
So what does it take to live to 100 or beyond? As you will see, the answer is not what we expect. Julianne Holt-Lunstead is a researcher at Brigham Young University, and she addressed this very question in a series of studies of tens of thousands of middle-aged people. And she looked at every aspect of their lifestyle, their diet, their exercise, their marital status, how often they went to the doctor, whether they smoked or drank, etc. She recorded all of this, and then she and her colleagues sat tight and waited for 7 years to see who would still be breathing. And of the people left standing, what reduced their chances of dying the most? That was her question. So let's now look at her data in summary, going from the least powerful predictor to the strongest. Whether you're lean or overweight, you can stop feeling guilty about this because it's only in third place. How much exercise you get is next, still only a moderate predictor. Did anybody here know that having a flu vaccine protects you more than doing exercise? And getting towards the top predictors are two features of your social life. First, your close relationships. These are the people that you can call on for a loan if you need money suddenly, who will call the doctor if you're not feeling well, or who will take you to the hospital, or who will sit with you if you're having an existential crisis, if you're in despair. Those people, that little clutch of people are a strong predictor, if you have them, of how long you'll live. And then something that surprised me, something that's called social integration. This means how much you interact with people as you move through your day. How many people do you talk to? And these mean both your weak and your strong bonds. So not just the people you're really close to who mean a lot to you, but like, do you talk to the guy who every day makes you your coffee? Do you talk to the postman? Do you talk to the woman who walks by your house every day with her dog? Do you play bridge or poker or have a book club? Those interactions are one of the strongest predictors of how long you live.
Yes, living to 100 is always a challenge, especially in light of most of us actually living or trying to live just to reach 70, 70 years for those who don't know what 70 is, 70 years, which is what we were taught is our fair and maximum share of time on God's earth, but which many people show every month and every year, everywhere, that you can actually live to be 100 years old and more. And one of those people is the mighty Sparrow, who just turned 87 and who we will feature a little later in today's show. Yes, the Congo man, the mighty Sparrow at 87, and still doing what he does best, later on today on Earl at Large.